like to welcome you to our Sabbath School science demonstration this morning, and it's all about gravity. Our text today is taken from Hebrews 1:3, that little part that talks about God upholding all things by the word of his power. It might appear, as we look out, that our universe kind of takes care of itself. Clouds drift by. The moon circles the earth, and planets circle the sun without any visible hand to hold it in place. It seems to do it just all by itself. And if you're looking, I'm on slide 6 now in our little presentation. But this orderly motion that we see in the heavens is maintained by the law of gravitation. This law was discovered by Sir Isaac Newton about 300 years ago, and on page 9 you'll see a picture of a painting of Sir Isaac Newton. Gravity. It's not really understood. We know some things about it, but even the scientists of our day don't understand everything about gravity, but we do know that it causes objects to attract and hold on to each other. This force between the earth and the moon, for example, causes the tides, and it keeps the moon from escaping from our vision and just flying off into outer space. Gravity is somehow able to act across millions of miles of empty space. It never turns off. It never varies. It can't be canceled, and you can't shield yourself from it. You can't put some kind of shield away around you, some kind of suit, and then jump off of a precipice and not fall down to the ground below. It's like a glue. It's always active. It holds our universe together. And if gravity were turned off for one instant, chaos would occur. And it's just like if it were a light switch and God could just turn the switch off for an instant or two, chaos in our universe would occur. And I want to show you that chaos with this tennis ball. All you need is a tennis ball and a length of string about 5 feet long. It needs to be shorter for me. And we're going to step out. We're already outside, but we're going to step to a different part of our parking lot. Before I do, this tennis ball represents the earth, and my hand holding it, I'm going to be swinging around, represents the sun, and how the earth rotates around the sun. And the reason that happens, of course, God is behind it all, is because of this gravitational force between the sun and the planets. All the planets that are rotating around the sun are held in its place, in their places, by gravitation. So we're going to step over here, and I hope I remember how to do this. I've practiced it. And so what we're going to do is we're going to swing this around, and I'll let Ashley try this in a minute, and anyone else who wants to try this. And I need to protect myself now. So remember, first of all, Ashley, what is this? No, what does it represent? Oh, never mind. Okay, we're going to, oops, I can't do it that way. Okay, we're just going to swing this around. And remember, this represents the earth, and my hand represents the sun, and the string represents what?
Gravity.
And if God turned the switch of gravity off, what do you think would happen to the earth? Well, let's just see if I can figure this. I think I better swing it a little more. And, whoops. And, wow, it left space. It left our space. Okay, if Ashley will hurry and get it, she can try again. Were you able to get that off? Could you see it fly off? Maybe. Who knows? Okay, Ashley's going to try. Of course, this is a 5-foot length of string, so she has to make it smaller. Okay, our pupil is coming up, our Sabbath School pupil, and she's going to swing the earth around and see what happens when, whoops, you threw it, try again, you need practice, She threw it. We're supposed to let go, and it flies on its own. Any way you want, but you just swing it and let go. You come over here and rotate this way so that when you let go, it flies off.
Right.
Okay.
I was rotating it the other way.
Okay, no problem. No. Okay, maybe that will work.
Yeah, we'll come back and get you. Go to our place.
Thank you, Ashley. We can practice more.
And we've said all this because?
Because God holds everything up. He is the master behind it all. And without Him, everything would be in chaos. Our universe, well, I don't think we'd have a universe without Him. So thank you very much. And I hope you turn in next Sabbath for our another demonstration about God's universe.